There is no surer sign an election is just a week away. Both sides upping the ante on the campaign trail today and wheeling out the big guns. Chris Minns was joined by the Prime Minister on his home turf, while in the battleground of Penrith, it was a former leader charming the voters he first won over more than 20 years ago.
There's a reason John Howard is the man they call when the Liberal Party needs a boost.
Hello.
Shaking hands, taking selfies, making small talk in the heart of Penrith, where former Minister Stuart Ayres is fighting for survival.
This is a marginal seat. You've got to work hard. He knows that. I know that. Don Perrottet knows that. And the Labor Party knows that too.
At the age of 83, John Howard is the Liberal Party's gold standard of campaigning.
Still perpendicular.
Yeah.
It's a good start when you get to my age.
A former Prime Minister, still recognisable, still welcome on the hustings, something Labor MPs aren't feeling about the man he replaced after Paul Keating's unwelcome intervention into foreign policy this week.
Another former Prime Minister has made headlines this week for speaking out.
I'll leave that to his own party.
Do you have an opinion on the AUKUS pact?
Look, I'll leave that to the Labor Party to deal with. That's their issue.
This visit wasn't highly publicised or carefully choreographed, and yet people have still been lining up to shake Mr Howard's hand. The Liberals will be hoping that kind of popularity rubs off. The seat of Penrith is on a knife's edge.
We never take a vote for granted. This is the community I grew up in. I'm at home here. I feel pretty confident.
The Premier was hoping for some stardust of his own, pressing the flesh in another must-win seat.
Go to the man. Yeah.
That's right.
Once held by Gladys Berejiklian, Willoughby is no longer considered safe. Tim James facing a strong independent challenge.
Vote well and vote for Tim.
A week from polling day, the messages are now well honed.
Done.
On a tour of Meadowbank TAFE in the seat of Ryde, the Premier drilling down into his infrastructure record.
During construction, they drive jobs growth. And we know that that is all at risk under Labor because they don't have an economic plan for the future.
It's pretty good. What do you give me out of 10 for that?
Oh, yeah, that's a 10.
That's a 10. There we go.
It's the verdict of the rest of New South Wales he's sweating on. Jane Azzopardi, Nine News.
Well, he could be the Labor leader's secret weapon to win Sydney's inner west. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese keeping it real on the hustings today at a Balmain pub on St Patrick's Day.
A Labor Prime Minister at the pub where the movement was born 130 years ago.
Two rushes.
Attempting to secure the party a clean sweep of mainland states.
I want Chris Minns, who will be a fantastic Labor Premier, to have a majority on the floor of the Legislative Assembly.
The would-be Premier in lockstep with Albo and Inner West God at the Unity Hall in Balmain.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Here's the Labor in Balmain.
Leaning on the luck of the Irish. A beer for Balmain.
Absolutely. On St Patrick's Day, you're allowed to have a beer in the afternoon, I reckon.
A seat Labor lost when it lost government back in 2011, 12 years later, this is the redemption tour. Rolling out the Prime Minister signals Labor is bullish about retaking the seat of Balmain from the Greens.
I'll be working to do everything I can to make sure that Balmain returns to the Labor fold.
At a nearby Leichhardt childcare centre, backing in the opposition's pledge to boost the workforce.
What do you think, future education minister, about my drawing?
Very good, very good.
And from childcare...
What's happening?
...to after-school care...
There's no chance of me stopping that.
Chris Minns at the Wanderers Soccer Development Facility in Rooty Hill, shooting for the votes of Western Sydney parents.
Oh, nice to see you, mate.
Promising $6.5 million to set up an after-school care program with the A-League team.
Getting away from the television, spending time with mates in a safe and secure environment.
A minibus would pick up children from various schools in the area and drop them at the Wanderers Fives facility, where there are up to 120 spots available for 2 hours of free care.
So we'll have an on-site teacher to be able to assist with any educational requirements.
And it wouldn't be a Friday on the campaign trail without a party.
Today is my birthday.
Not just any birthday, Toon Lim raised the bat, 100 years old. His birthday wish, a special guest appearance from his local member in Kogra,
hey!
Chris Minns.
Hey!
Hooray! The Labor leader hoping this is just the beginning of his celebrations.
And state politics reporter Liz Daniels joins us now from Balmain. Liz, the first votes can be cast tomorrow.
That's right, Georgie. With the rising popularity of early voting, pre-polling and postal voting, we don't really have an election day anymore. It's more like an election week. From tomorrow, more than 2,000 early voting centres will open right across the state, with about 30% of people to have their say before next Saturday. And with that starting gun about to be fired, Georgie, that's exactly why we saw that both camps up the ante this morning.